So today we're going to be talking about aneurysms and how they're important in neuro-ophthalmology. And as you know, the circle of Willis is where the aneurysms that are of importance to us occur. And when we're dealing with the circle of Willis aneurysms, we really are talking about the bifurcation aneurysms. So when we have an aneurysm at the junction of the internal carotid artery and the posterior communicating artery, that aneurysm is really important to us because the third nerve travels right parallel to the PCOM artery. So as it's leaving the midbrain, the third nerve and the posterior communicating artery are parallel, and so aneurysms that affect the PCOM artery often produce third nerve palsies. And because the pupil fibers are on the outside of the nerve, it often produces a painful pupil-involved third nerve palsy. In addition, anterior communicating and anterior cerebral artery aneurysms can compress on the optic nerve, either one side or both sides, because the optic nerves are very close to the anterior circulation. And internal carotid artery aneurysm in the cavernous sinus produce ophthalmoplegia. So the intracavernous aneurysm can get quite large, a giant aneurysm, and it can produce a third, a fourth, a fifth, or a sixth nerve dysfunction, as well as a Horner syndrome. In addition, the suprasellar aneurysm is very close to the optic apparatus and can produce an optic neuropathy or a chiasmal problem, a bitemporal hemianopsia. And the ophthalmic takeoff is the first intracranial branch of the internal carotid artery of the head, and so ophthalmic artery aneurysms can present with optic neuropathies and vision loss. The MCA aneurysms, we really don't see those, but if it bleeds, it can cause a homonymous hemianopsia. The basilar tip aneurysm, that one we do see, and as opposed to the PCOM, because both third nerves are right leaving the midbrain in the interpeduncular cistern, bilateral third is something that can occur from basilar aneurysm or from treatment of basilar aneurysm. And then vertebral aneurysms can produce disease either from downstream ischemia like the Wallenberg syndrome from pica involvement or nystagmus or downstream ischemic events. So the major aneurysm that we really need to be worried about is the PCOM aneurysm at the junction of the ICA and the PCOM that produces the pupil-involved painful third nerve palsy. And so an ophthalmologist needs to know about that aneurysm. The cavernous sinus aneurysm, the giant intracavernous internal carotid artery aneurysm, produces ophthalmoplegia. And the anterior circulation aneurysms, ACA, ACOM, and ICA, produce optic neuropathies or chiasmopathies because they're involving the anterior visual pathway. And the basilar tip aneurysm for the bilateral third. So you need to know a little bit about the aneurysms, the most common locations, and the presenting neuro-ophthalmic findings.